Hey, this is WhyBeAre with BeamNG.drive, and today we're going to be taking a look at a mod for the Gravel T series. Now, this mod is actually only compatible with the T75. So all these T65s up here, they're as good as worthless. They're not going to be in this video at all. We need the T75. And really, the only difference between a T75 and a T65 is that the T75 has that extra set of wheels in the back, where the T65, well, it doesn't have that set of wheels in the back. So there's a not a significant difference between those, but this mod is only compatible with the T75. And to look at the mod, I wanted to move my truck over to about here because this is a much better location to be in than where we started at. So to access the mod, you're going to open up the parts menu. Then you're going to go to the series frame tab, open that up. Then you're going to go to series uplift and open that up. Now you have a 75 trailer option, which is where the mod lives. So there are three parts to the mod. The first one is the 75 reefer trailer, which is just a normal trailer, which you normally think of when you think of what kind of trailer would go on this kind of truck. This is what I envision. It even has a cooler. So this is some very important food or something that needs to be cooled in here. At least that's what I imagine. The next one is the 75 lowboy trailer, which is the kind you would use to load up wheeled vehicles and then strap them down, or, well, just about anything that could be in an open air trailer, actually. And you notice when I hit the parking brake, that back part did lower and raise depending on if it was on or off. And the last one is the 75 road train trailer. And this one is not the biggest of road trains. It's only two trailers long, but it still is quite a handful to try to drive that many trailers. But I'm not going to do that yet. First, we're going to start off by driving the 75 reefer trailer, and then we'll drive the other ones later on. If you want to drive this trailer good, you have two camera options that really make sense. The first one is the hood camera, the second one is the interior camera, because the exterior camera is unmodified from the normal truck, which means the camera focuses on the truck and the truck only. The camera doesn't even know that there's a trailer there, so if you actually wanted to see the whole trailer in the camera, you have to zoom out a ton, and then you would have a camera angle that looks like this, which doesn't really work out well because you end up swerving all over the place because you can't see what the truck itself is doing. You can only see what the trailer's doing. So I end up always overcompensating, and then we kind of swerve like this as I try to stay on the road. So I have to zoom out even more to have a camera angle like this. And that's usually a usable camera angle to me where I can actually see the truck. Now, of course, if you have the train, it gets even worse than that one. But you have one more option where it's like this, where you can see the truck, but the trailer's kind of there, but not there at the same time. Ooh! I think I just hit the trailer on that tree. Yeah, it's not flat anymore. I didn't exactly test that. I just decided we could drive this around here without issue. I guess that's not exactly true. My only testing was on that grid map and stuff. I didn't see how well this thing would fit. We need like a sign that says this is too short. You won't fit. But anyways though, back to this camera angle. You'll see that the interior of this trailer is non-existent. So you can't put anything in it. It's just going to be an empty trailer all the time. Now the weight of the trailer is similar to that of an empty trailer, as far as I can tell. It's only about 6 tons, which, although heavy, isn't that heavy for a trailer like this one if it was loaded up. Or even empty ones, I think, can weigh more than that. It's not quite 6 tons, actually. I think it was a little under 6 tons, but don't quote me on that, because I'm not 100% sure. And it does tip pretty easy, though. I must point that out. It's very tip-happy, and the reason for that is quite simple. The suspension design is, well, it's a bar, and then you have tires attached to it. So you can make this thing tip pretty easy because that is not like a real suspension setup, really. It's just a bar. You know, there's no springs or coilovers or leaf spring or anything. It's just a bar. Can I fit in the tunnel? Woo, just barely. So this one, you got to use that camera angle. Otherwise, where's my truck? Can't see it. But yeah, you can drive this thing around pretty fast. I mean, it's a lot faster than I would normally expect, but that is, of course, until you get to a corner, then you got to slow down. But it does a pretty good job of going in a straight line. It doesn't feel that much slower than just the truck. And right now I'm going to push it really hard so we can crash into something in a dramatic fashion. So no brakes, only gas, and you can see there's the trailer tipping, just like I said, and there is what the trailer does in an impact. And then it rolls. It's like, I'm done, I'm rolling over. So you can see there's very minimal damage to the trailer itself because the truck took most of the impact, and actually it didn't get the truck itself that damaged either. So it was very, very low impact because we were on such a windy road. I couldn't get up to speed as much as I wanted. Now, one thing I haven't done is take a closer look at the J-beam structure, and since I'm crashing this up, I might as well take a look at it. they can see what the top looks like from the top, but the sides you can't see it unless you're on the inside, and you can see it there. And the only part you can see on the side is this part right here, which is actually modeled, so it makes it very realistic if you were to try to drive under this, and I don't think many cars would fit like you always see in the movies. Yeah, good luck fitting a car under that. That is really short. And then for the back, you'll notice that this back part for the underride guard is not actually modeled, so I'm not exactly sure what'll happen in a rear-end collision, but I'll probably try one out later on and see. And now I want to go ahead and use the 75 lowboy, but I don't want to do it here. I want to drive on a new place just so we get a lot of variety going. So let's go ahead and go to East Coast, USA. All right, now we need to get my truck next to my truck, except one truck's like a truck and the other one's a truck. You know, this is a truck. That one's a truck. You get what I mean, hopefully. I am just being dumb. How about an easier way to make sense? We got my pickup truck, and then we got my truck. So let's go ahead and try to load my pickup truck onto my truck and see how that works. So just driving right up that ramp. No issue there. Mouse is in the way. We'll move him over. And then can we actually drive up to that other section? Or what if we really drive at it? Like we go. Yeah. I don't know why I would want to have my truck like that, besides the fact that it looks kind of cool like that. So you know what? It's going to stay like that. All right. So let's add a few more cars. We can add the student driver, Ibishu. That should be able to fit no problem. And we're going to just pack on the cars until we can't fit anymore. And if I was really crazy, what I could do is put a truck with a trailer on this, and then I put something on that trailer. But I don't know if that'll be stable. I'm pretty sure I tried to go around a corner, it would just flip over. I didn't hit him. That's just really tight parking. I'm the best at this parking thing. All right, and I think we could do a pigeon in the back. It looks like we have just enough room to like put a pigeon back there, and then we're pretty much out of space. It's gonna be a tight fit for the pigeon. Actually, how's the pigeon even gonna climb that ramp now that I think about it? Like that, can I just go up the middle? Does it work? I mean, it's too thin, isn't it? Oh, plus it's a tricycle, whatever. So, oh, look at that. Oh, that's actually kind of convenient. So the ramp is faked in a way where like that whole section is a ramp, so you don't have to like line your wheels up with the ramp. So that's kind of nice. So park that pigeon. And is this the truck? I think so, right? Yep. Parking brake off. Wait, hey. Come on. The back isn't closing. Oh, no. Well, let's see if they can stay on then. I don't think the pigeon will because it just doesn't have enough traction with only three wheels, but the other two might. Goodbye, pigeon. I'll miss ya. All right, so the other two, they're sturdy, though. They're not going to roll around as much. Yeah, the pigeon just sucks for that because it has three really skinny wheels. So it just can't hold. It just slides even with the parking brake on. You know, with these two, they have pretty thick wheels and there's four of them, so they're able to hold their positions a little bit better. But, you know, if I slam on my brakes or something, they'll still go flying. You know what? Might be close to slam into a wall or something and see what happens to the cars on the trailer and all that. So let's do full speed ahead into whatever's in front of us. It might be a wall or probably more likely a tree that we're going to hit. But, you know, whatever we hit, we're going to hit it hard. At least, hopefully, in the 70-mile-per-hour range, that's going to be a good hit. Oh, no, it's uphill. Uphill, why you betray me like this? Downhill. All right, now we're talking. All right, here we go. This is the best speed I'm going to get. So let's go and just hit that tree right there. It's a nice big tree to hit right there. We're going to kind of slide into it. All right, this is going to be interesting. Oh, no, the cars are falling off the trailer. I just noticed. I put this one at 100 times slow-mo because I really want to see what happens here. All right, now it's going to happen. Those cars are still moving at 70 miles per hour at this point. At least, I would think. So what's going to happen to them? Like, my drivers, he's just going to... Ooh, it's like being rear-ended in the head. Yeah. Oh my goodness, that's a cool crash. That is a cool crash. This is why you strap down your vehicles. You ever see a tow truck driver not strap down the vehicle? No, because they know they should strap down their vehicles. Otherwise, something like that could happen. And you don't want that to happen. I speed it up just a bit. Oh my goodness, smokescreen! I can't see nothing now. At least nothing happened in the smoke screen as far as I could tell. The Ibishu just kind of slid away. One thing I don't know, though, is why did the back end fail to lift up? Is it, like, because I drove the cars on it that caused it? So if I let it go all the way, it will come back up there, no problem. It must have been when I drove the cars on the back, it somehow found a way to damage it where it wouldn't pick back up, is what I'm guessing. You know, I'll try that again to see if I can figure that out. Out of the way, pigeon. I'm first. So we drive up with the truck, right? And we'll just stop it right here. And will it lift still? Okay, so it still lifts after the truck. I wonder if it had something to do with when I kind of crashed into the back trying to, you know, get up there. So there, I did that again. Does it lift still? Yes. Alright, now we'll try driving the Ibishu Covet up onto it. You know what? I want a different color. I don't want two silver cars. Let me just change the color real quick. I'm looking at this. It's like, this can't have two silver. Well, the truck's already blue, so let's go yellow. Like a really nice yellow, you know? It's like a taxi cab yellow. I like taxi cab yellow. It's a good color for cars sometimes. Especially if you're a taxi cab. You can't get better than that. If you're a police officer, it's a really good color too because you'll trick people. Alright, so let's see. Can it still close? Okay, it can still close. So is it the pigeon that broke it? Or was it just some coincidence? I don't know. It's weird. Alright, so pigeon is... Like, I don't really see the pigeon breaking it. It's the lightest one there is. I don't want to pull it up too far. Alright, there we go. Now it closed up. Which should hold the pigeon in place when we accelerate. And I think I'll just leave the pigeon there. I think that's the best spot for it. So here we go. Yeah, now the pigeon's actually holding its spot. That's good. All right, we're going to try to navigate through the town with this really long trailer. And all these steep hills. I mean, the total weight of this trailer, I think I mentioned it before, is like less than 2 tons. And then with these vehicles on it, it probably weighs just a bit more than a single trailer, but still less than the double trailer, which I'll be looking at later on. But right now, it's doing pretty good. We're able to accelerate up to speed reasonably well. So we're already at 50 miles per hour, and obviously this isn't no sports car or nothing, but that's a pretty good rate of acceleration. How's the deceleration? Pretty decent. I don't know if the trailers have any sort of braking mechanism now that I think about it. No, pigeon! Pigeon's gone! He cannot hold on! And I was watching the pigeon so hard, I almost just tipped the rest of them off the trailer. That would have been great. Alright, I'm going to try to tip him off the trailer then. So we're just going to try to tip this thing. So we go into a corner real hard and fast, and then we turn at the last second, and that should tip it. Although I need a better camera angle to see what's going on up ahead, because these trees are so low. Alright, right up here, we're only going about 40 miles per hour, so I don't know if I'll be able to do it there. Thinking I'm going to need a little bit more speed, because it's all uphill, so it's like I can't go fast. But here we're gonna try it. Tip it. Not happening. Oh, did the... Whoa! The Covet's fallen, though. Alright, we got a little downhill. No brakes. I'm just gonna try for the tip, and I'm gonna crash at the end if it is necessary to do that. Covet is gone! Let's tip that truck off. Come on! And the truck is gone, too! Oh my goodness, the flaps on the back are just freaking out. Oh! The flaps on the back just grabbed a tree or something. That was kind of unusual. Oh, hey! It looks like the back does have some sort of braking mechanism because I hit the brakes and the wheels stopped moving. Like I said earlier, I was curious if the trailer had brakes, so I want to go ahead and do a test for that. And the easiest way to do that is to get the environment and put it to zero gravity after you accelerate for a little bit, so the rear wheel should be spinning and in the air. And now we're going to just hit the brakes and see what it does. Okay, so it definitely stopped it. So there is a braking mechanism in the trailers. And I was looking at that not from necessarily a realism standpoint, but just did the mod implement that standpoint? And it did, so that is definitely a huge help for stopping this thing. If we only stopped with the front brakes, it'd be really difficult. But I wasn't sure if it would have the brakes just because it's only a single piece, so there's no thing in specific that says, oh yes, this has brakes, you know? Anyways, though, I think that's all we're going to do for that trailer driving it around. So let's go ahead and do the last trailer. And this one, I need a place that doesn't have a lot of trees. So we're going to go to industrial site and drive it around there. And if you haven't already guessed, the reason I went to a place with no trees is so that way I can actually see what I'm doing. Because if I went to a place with trees, I would probably really struggle with being able to see the whole trailer without being blocked out by trees that are right above me. At least that's what my thought process was. So I went here because we have a racetrack that doesn't have trees anywhere above it. Except it does have this. Can I fit? Oh, tight fit. Yes, that is a... That's not quite as tight as I thought it was, but it is close. So yeah, we're just going to drive around this for a bit with a crazy camera angle like this so you can actually kind of see what the trailer does through the corners and all that. So I'm going to take this at a reasonable rate of speed, but I don't even know if I'm going to be able to keep this thing like kind of on the road the whole time because, well, it's difficult. Like, the truth of the matter is it is not easy to drive a vehicle with trailers, especially on a windy road like this. Like, if I was playing a truck simulator game, I would not take this mission. Because this is really difficult on when the corners get tighter to like make sure you don't cut the corner right there. Like, I was so close to just cutting that corner with the rear of the trailer. Luckily, I didn't, but it was close. Like, a corner like this one, I have no idea if I can do this without just totally cutting into the dirt through the corner. I'm gonna try, but I don't know about this. Come on. Oh, I had to put my front in the dirt. No! No, stop cutting the corners, see? That's not what my goal was. My goal was to stay on the road as much as possible, not cut corners. So yeah, it's difficult to really drive this thing with precision. What if you try to drive it fast? Let's do that instead. Because I've proven precision, difficult. What about fast? How difficult is fast? So no brakes, pretty much, unless I absolutely need to. Yeah. Not yet. Stop feeling like you're going to tip over. Felt like it was going to tip over right there for a second. Oh, I can make this corner less severe if I go like this direction. That way I don't have to worry about it tipping. I'm a genius sometimes. Driving from way back here feels weird. Like, it feels like it's super third person or something. Because, you know, driving in third person, you never sit this far away from where you are. It just feels so weird. And yeah, I'm going really fast now, so this trailer's going all in the dirt and stuff. Oh, don't tip on me! Don't you dare tip on me! Uh-oh. Wait, we're good. Thank you! I have so much weight, it's actually difficult to tip this whole thing all at once, I think. I mean, it's just such a big trailer. You can't tip this. All 11 and a half tons or whatever. Yeah, it's not like it's a loaded trailer, it's empty. Which probably makes it a little bit more stable, because when you load things up, it probably becomes more top-heavy. Unless you load it up with, like, rocks on the bottom and feathers on top or something. But once again, like I said earlier, you can't put anything in this trailer. It's empty. No matter what. Unless you glitch it in. Alright, I want to crash. It's not very fast, but... Oh my goodness! That trailer just takes out the cab. I really gotta see that one again because that was crazy. That was like a 30 mile per hour crash, and that's not one of those crashes where it's like, oh, he might have lived. That's one of those ones where that's gonna kill you. That was a really brutal crash. So I'm gonna just do it again right into this tree and see what happens. So we're only going 31 miles per hour here, okay? Remember that, 31 miles per hour. That's not that fast. That's nothing in the grand scheme of things. That's slower than the IIHS does their tests, right? And just looking at what's happening, it's, oh my goodness. Like, the driver is supposed to be in there, and, well, there's no place for him to be anymore. It just totally crushes the cab. We'll speed it up a little bit, because I think it's done crushing it. But that's just, like, you're not going to survive that. The steering wheel is inside of your chest. That is crazy. Alright, so now I'm gonna do some crash testing when we crash into the trailers, which makes me want to go to a map that's a little bit flatter so I can line things up nice and easy. So let's go ahead and head over to grid map. The first thing I want to do is crash into the back of a trailer and see what happens. I want to see how much damage the trailer gets and how much damage the car crashing into it gets as well. So let's go ahead and start off by grabbing the normal trailer, which is the first one we'll crash into, and get it into position. And getting it to position is in the path of a suspension test, so we can go ahead and do that and see how well the trailer holds up on this. Now remember, the trailer suspension is a bar that goes straight across. So it's going to be interesting to see how it holds up. And it kind of just bounces over the bumps. Like, it's in the air half the time. Which must be really weird feeling if you were actually in that trailer for some reason. It would feel very strange, I'm thinking. You can speed this up a little bit so you can kind of see just the bouncing. Like, there, you can really see it bounce, bounce, bounce. I don't know. It actually looked kind of smooth for a total lack of modern vehicle suspension where it's just that bar across. It's interesting. And then, since we're driving all the way over here, we might as well crash into the wall just because it's there. Like, that's why I have to stop anyways. So why not just throw in a crash right there? And we'll do this one at 4x slow-mo. That's a speed I never use. Just give you a different look at things. Or is that 2x? No, that was 4x. And once again, the trailer is just destroying the driver in these situations here. Alright, so now we're just going to take this truck and hit it at the maximum speed the truck can reach from back here, which is probably going to be like 100 miles per hour. So we're going to hit it hard. And I want to hit it hard. It's not realistic, but it's just to see how much damage can I do to that trailer, and then what happens to the truck as well, just because I'm curious. Well, it looks like it's going to be closer to 90, 95, but it's up there, that's for sure. Now, if you remember correctly, the underride guard is not J-beam. So we'll drive right through that, as you'll see right here. And then we'll crash directly into the trailer, which should look kind of awkward and weird. So yeah, right through the guard. And the first thing we hit is the trailer itself. So gotta get both the car and the trailer kind of in this frame. And, well, car. You see, that's why you have underride guards, because the car is just, the driver's been origami. He has been origamied up and he is not going to be okay. Trailer is holding up reasonably well so far, I guess. I mean, I don't really know how much damage a trailer would receive in a crash like this. This is a little bit more than I personally expected, but it might be realistic. It's one of those things where I really couldn't find a good comparison for something like this exactly, so I'm just kind of winging it. How's the truck look, though? Yeah. Yeah, there's no way that driver's okay. Just, no. Like, the back of the truck's literally in the driver's seat. It's not gonna happen. So one more look at the trailer. You can go ahead and pull the truck out. Can it drive? No, that truck's broken. Here's a better look at it, though. And we can reset it. Reset the truck. And now let's hit it with the BTR, which is a lot more heavy, so it should do a lot more damage. I'm thinking the top speed we'll reach with this is probably going to be 70-ish miles per hour. I can't remember exactly how fast this thing is, but I know it's really big and really heavy, so it shouldn't be able to go that fast. I mean, if it reached the same speed as the truck, I would honestly be shocked, because that is amazing. It shouldn't, though. It might, because I've seen weirder things, but it shouldn't. And I'm going to mostly be watching the truck, because the BTR, well, he's indestructible, basically. You can crash into things all day, and nothing will happen. So the BTR is on automatic gas mode, so I can just fully focus on doing the camera work right here, so you can see what happens to that trailer. You can see, just pressing it in. It's like a button, or a lever, or a dog door or something he's trying to open up. Like, just pressing right through it. It is unbelievable how much it's just, I mean, it really is just driving right through it, dude. I don't know what's going to be left with this thing. Is the BTR even slowing down? Maybe a little bit, but it is, now it's like popping a wheelie, like I gotta keep pushing this thing. And it just is pushing it. I'm really glad I put this one at 100x slow-mo, because this is impressive watching this thing just get crushed like this. And now there's like a little triangle right here. I'm not gonna make a joke about the Illuminati, but I know you're thinking it. Your little Illuminati hole. That sounds so weird. It almost sounds like an insult. You Illuminati hole. And wow. I mean, the whole back of this truck is just, I mean, that's I can't even put into words how crazy this crash is so far. I think we can speed it up a little bit more, because it looks like it's mostly done. Yeah, it's kind of just The crash is done, but there's still some momentum to get rid of, so the whole truck's flipping up right now. That was an interesting one. Oh my goodness, are you serious? It's staying like that. Hold up. I need to drive through the Illuminati hole. I gotta do it. I gotta drive through it. Come on! No! Oh, I can't do it. There's something invisible there, I think. Or maybe I just hit the fuel tank. I'll try it one more time. I'll be a little bit, like, in between the fuel tanks. There we go! Yeah! Aha! And I don't think I hit the fuel tank. I think I just hit something invisible from the trailer. Yeah, the connectors to the exhaust. That's probably what I hit. Oh, well. I got to drive through it, though. That's what's important. As stupid as it is, I did it. All right, so you can calm down. You don't have to accelerate anymore. I was afraid to take it off earlier, though, because I thought it might tip over. We could actually drive a bigger car through that, though. It's a pretty big hole. Drive the 200BX in chrome. See if I can push those exhausts out the way. There we go. That's fun to do. Like, it's just so nonsensical that that thing is standing somehow. Like, it just doesn't look like it should, but it does. Alright. So now I want to get rid of the B shoe, but I don't feel like it at the same time. So instead, we're just going to use the ATTE and ram the trailer with that. And once again, we will not be using turbo, just the normal acceleration. And I gotta make sure I don't do anything too dumb through the suspension test, because this thing doesn't go through it like the BTR, where it has these massive tires that just roll right over it. This one has some thinner tires, which make it a little more difficult. Again, though, this is basically indestructible, so my focus will be on the trailer, and I'm not gonna worry too much about what happens to the ATTE, because, well, not much is gonna happen. It's just gonna destroy whatever's in front of it. There we go. It's on automatic throttle mode. Speed it up a little bit until it makes contact. And it's kind of just pressing it in again. Oh, it's kind of clipping inside of it too. Oh, only out in the middle part. See, it's a little bit inside because I wasn't totally centered because I was trying to mess with the camera instead of paying exactly attention. But I think it's good enough to get a nice crush going. So is this going to look exactly the same like the BTR, even though the ATTE is so much bigger? Maybe. I don't know. Hold on. Oh, no. I think it's crushing it more. Like you would expect. I think it is crushing it more. Speed this up some. Yeah, that is more crush. Unfortunately, it's so much crush that all the power of the vehicle kind of gets pushed upwards. So, it just makes a mess of trailer. Interesting. Well then, what happens if the trailer has two of them? Let's go through this one, the road train. I don't know if I'll try the smaller cars on this one. I might just do just the ATTE and that's it. And maybe I'll do it with the turbo. Maybe. I think I will. Just because I can. So I turboed it up. Whoa. And we're going to hit 80 miles per hour. That's about all I'm going to do. I don't want to go so fast that causes glitchiness or anything like that. I did want to go fast where I could hurt it. Alright, two trailers to plow through. Let's see it happen. Trailer one. The Silver Trade Lines truck. This one seems to crash a little differently. It seems like it condenses down a little bit easier, doesn't it? Maybe not. It's just kind of an illusion for the angle I'm crashing at it. Like, the inside is just going inside of my ATTE. I think that's what's happening. Because from this angle, it looks like it's just going squish. Like a straight squish. I don't even know how to explain it any other way. It's a squish, dude. That's what it is. And then trailer 2 is actually now the one getting damaged. So, basically, I could plow through both trailers at once with this thing. It's that strong and powerful. Speed it up some just to make it faster, because I saw most of the damage already. I just want to see what the outcome is now. Alright. VTR calm. And I think the trailer's got more damage on that one than the first one. I don't know if that's really true or not, but it looks like it. I mean, that trailer is... it's the size of, like... well, maybe a little bit bigger than an H cube, it seems like. It is so small. Alright. What about one more rear-ending thing? What if we rear-end the lowboy with a vehicle? Like, it wouldn't be a rear-end so much as we fly up it, right? If the parking brake's on, of course. So I'm going to put the parking brake on, use an off-road vehicle so we can have the ability to make it up that ramp for sure, and we'll see what happens. So we'll get the V8 Vanster Off-Road Edition in orange, flame orange even, and use that one. We're just going to go full throttle, just like the other tests, except this one will probably be the highest speed because this is a pretty light vehicle. Won't be the most damaging though, because ATTE does so much damage from its weight. Alright, so here we go. Ramp it. Let's see what the ramp does. Does it go actually? Uh-oh. Oh no. It made it. It made it. It somehow made it. Alright, speed it up. Oh, it's gonna fly right into the... it's gonna fly over it. No! I was going too fast. I did not foresee this outcome. I was going so fast, I'm literally gonna fly over it. Well, that's actually impressive how close it is to crashing. Like, that's within inches. Oh wait, it's gonna hit it in the back. Oh, there's a little tiny, tiny impact. That's like nothing. I think it was enough to ruin my suspension though. Well, that's not quite what I was looking for. We need to slow that down a bit. And if we're gonna slow it down, we might as well try a different vehicle that's a little bit heavier and slower. So if we do the Roamer Sheriff Edition, that should work out pretty well. Now, even with a slower vehicle, I really want to go probably really slow on this, because I'm thinking like highway speeds is going to be too much. We need to hit this really slow for it to not just bounce over the truck like it did last time. So I'm going to drop the speed like way down, like in the 40 range, I think. And if this truly might even be too fast as well, I'm not really sure, but we're gonna try it out. So 40, 45 area, and up the ramp, and it's still going high. That's actually probably the best speed I could have got, because it's like it just lands right on the roof. If I did it any slower, it would have been such a low impact, I don't know if it would have been worth it. That turned out pretty well. At least I think it did. Take a close look at the way the truck got smushed. That looks pretty interesting. I don't think I've seen a crash like that before. And let's try something heavier. Let's try a truck with a trailer. There we go. We're going to use a truck with a trailer to jump my truck with a trailer. I want to see if I can actually jump it with a double trailer. That'll just look so weird. Having a double trailer truck jump the other truck. It's just... that's so unbelievably dumb, and I gotta do it. No, we could also do a suspension test for the double truck. I can't really, like, I zoom out so much, I can't even see where the truck heading, unfortunately, so it's kind of hard to see that and how it's actually doing anything. But yeah, it didn't flip over. That's the one positive I can make out of that. All right, so I'm just gonna go full throttle at this, because I think I'll get about the 45 mile per hour speed by the time I get there. Maybe a little bit more, actually. Might just fly right over after all. I don't know. Or maybe the trailer will break from the force of this impact because it's so heavy and stuff. I should use this camera angle to line it up. Makes it a little bit easier to do. Perfect alignment. Jump the other one. Oh god, this looks so dumb. It's not happening. It's not happening. Oh, but I made the jump. Oh, I made it. Oh my goodness, I can't believe that worked. Oh, I hope I can still drive after that. I really hope I can still drive this. It drives. It drives. Oh my goodness, that was so stupid. I can't believe it worked. I mean, the way it bounced off the top was just beautiful. Well, it didn't quite bounce off the top. It crushed the top, I guess. I almost want to do that one more time. I won't, though, because that would be boring. So the next thing I want to try to do, though, is get a bolide and try to drive it under a truck. So we'll go ahead and spawn that up. Then we'll make this trailer into the normal trailer. And now we'll try to drive it under the bolide. So let's go to the bolide, teleport the trailer over, and see if it fits. I don't think it'll fit, to be honest. I don't think it'll fit at all. But it's one of those things where you gotta try it. Oh, yeah. It's way too short. Is the dual trailer any better or no? Maybe? Ooh! It does fit under this one. It kind of glitches through it, but it goes through under it. No problem. Yeah, look at that, dude. That's cool. All right, what about a slightly taller car? So let's bring it up to 200 BX height, maybe? Is that a taller car? I'm pretty sure it is. I mean, the bolide's really short. So a little bit taller. Can you fit? No! I think the only car that will fit is the bolide, or cars that are even shorter than this one. The racing one might fit. It was a close one. So let's try the racing one out and see if it fits. Because I know the race one's pretty short and low to the ground. Yeah. It's a little bit shorter, although the wing is going to be crushed. Don't make it either. I can keep ramming it into it until it does fit, though. I want my car to fit. Oh, this is a roll cage, though. This is going to be hard. Like, we can't have a roll cage when we do this. That makes it 10 times harder to make it fit. Oh, it's totally stuck now. I'm gonna make it fit somehow. It will go through it and under the trailer. Under and through it, maybe, is a better way to say that. I don't know. I'm focused on making this work. Oh no, the car itself is starting to bend. Oh, it's all the roll cage's fault. Like the whole... Okay, we need to remove this roll cage here. That is the easiest solution. Just get rid of the roll cage, and then it'll fit under way easier. Now it's going to take like two tries and it's through, I bet. Not with the wing, of course. The wing's going to be murdered in the process. One try, and the wing stayed on! Impressive. Alright, so now if I drive under, does it fit cleanly, or does it still kind of hit the roof, though? Squeeze! Oh, it didn't fit at all, that one. Unexpected. Now the trailer's kind of crooked, so I'm gonna reset it. This poor car. Amazing that it still drives. So maybe that trailer's lower than the other one just because of the way it sits? I don't know. It might be. I mean, that's kind of what the conclusion I'm getting is from these crashes. And yeah, I'm just stretching this car in unusual, ugly ways. But it still drives because it's just damaging the top parts of the body because the roll cage is gone. So it doesn't transfer all the damage to the lower parts of the car. Oh, come on. It's stuck. Teleport out. Oh, that's in the truck. That's not what you're supposed to do. Go over here. Can you drive? Oh, that's the end for this car. What an amazing drive that was. So yeah, that's what happens when you try to drive under the truck. And now I have a couple more things I want to do. One of them is hit it with a hammer. Woo, the hammer even lines up in the right orientation. Perfect. So you place the hammer there. Move the truck out the way. Oh, it's stuck in the hammer a little bit. Teleport the truck out the way. And another thing, I might have damaged the truck where it made it sit lower than normal, so that probably didn't help. Start the hammer up. And I'm just going to wait for a little bit to make sure it gets up to its full speed, or at least close to it. So just play around in the inside. Oh, you can see the reflection of the hammer right there. You see it? Whoosh, whoosh. All right, now it should be up to speed. So let's head at it. Well, actually, first, what I should do is I should line the truck up right below it directly instead of kind of off center. That way it hits it in its most powerful part of its swing, I would think. Because the other one, it might just kind of clip it. This one, it'll hit it, you know? Get a nice big hit that'll hopefully make it fly, or at least do serious damage to it. So I actually had a really good timing coming into that, so it's not going to hit my truck and it's just gonna right into the trailer. Perfect. All right, so we tore the trailer off. That was a little underwhelming, but that's what happens when you do it. Let's go ahead and take a closer look at the trailer real quick. Yeah, that better be empty because that thing bent in. All right, now let's go ahead and replace the hammer with a cannon and shoot it with a cannon because I think that'll be fun. Whoops. I clicked wrong. Really? You won't go back? Okay, fine. I don't know what was going on there. There's the cannon. And where is my trick? Cannon! Why you got flipped like that? You gotta calm down. They're all flipping on me, literally. So I'll put it right back here. Make it right side up, and we'll shoot it into the back of the truck, and then we'll also shoot it into the side. Starting with the back, I'm gonna line it up as good as I can, which is about right there. Raise it. Ready, set, fire! It just ate my cannonball. Oh, there it is. Hi, cannonball. Good try, I guess. It didn't seem to do much damage. Keep shooting! That thing's pretty durable for cannonballs. Like, I'm shooting it, and it's just bending little by little to become that mangled mess that it's become. All right, let's try shooting it on the side. Where'd my... Shoot it from the inside! Yeah! I have no idea what I'm doing, but it looks interesting. And now it stopped being interesting. Okay, try this again. Cannon's gonna bounce and flip over. Don't do that. Spin it round. And line it up. Like so. A little bit more, a little bit more. Perfect. Up a little and fire. That's it? That was actually disappointing. That was so wimpy. That was just... It's nothing. It's a cannonball. Do some damage, you. Well. I wonder if we crush it with the crusher. How about trying that? So, large crusher. I don't know what will even fit in here exactly. I'm just going to like set it right here and... Well, there you go. Okay, now crush it. Yeah, that's just weird. Yeah, there goes the tires. Crush it again. I'm gonna keep crushing it until it stops getting crushed more. It's gonna slowly eat it all. It just keeps bringing it in little by little. Like, eating it and eating it and eating it and... I'm really curious how long until it freezes and glitches out. It sounds like it's gonna freeze and glitch out at any moment, and my frame rate is terrible at the moment as well. Eat the trailer! It tastes good. This is just crazy. I am compressing this good. Uh-oh. Well, there we go. We broke physics. As usual. I really need to get rid of that car. It throws me off so hard. I keep cycling through the vehicles wrong because I'm used to being only the cars I'm using. And that one keeps like, oh, I exist, you know. Yeah, I know. Now stop existing. That's a mean thing to say, but seriously, it's annoying me now. I want to try. Can we place it on the tilt board and then level it out and have it, like, not tipping? So first I'm going to just put it on the board so it'll not be flat in the air where I can't even drive on it. Hopefully that worked. Did it work? Yeah, what's with the camera for those things? Okay, that's worse. Alright, other car. Here's your chance to shine. Fix the tilt board. Good job. Alright, truck. Here's your chance to do something dumb. So like half the truck's gonna hang off of both ends for this to actually work, probably. Ta-da! It's cheating because like half the trailer's still on the ground, though. There we go. We could do it if we only had one trailer, probably. The two trailers is kind of like, nah, not really. Alright. Well, I think that's all I can think of right now at the moment to do with this, aside from some of the more destructive things like throwing it down the cliff. So let's go ahead and head to cliff to do that. Now, for all of these ones, I'm going to be using just the double trailer because I don't want to do all of them. So I'm going to do the one which I think is like the most interesting to watch. And I think the most interesting to watch would be the biggest one with the most wheels. And if you disagree with that, I don't know what's wrong with you. Oh, we're stuck. Okay, we're just going to sort of fall off the cliff then because that didn't work out. So here we go. I mean, I might get stuck because of how massive I am. This is going to be weird. This should go down all the way. This is not working, is it? Maybe it is. I guess it'll work. Barely. No, it's not. Yes, it is. No, it's not. Yes, it is. I can't make up my mind. Just say it kept going. All right, this sucks. Let's just not do the cliff then and move on to brutal slope. Now, I really have no idea if this will even work because we're going to be using two trailers at really high rates of speed. That's just asking for it to not work and crash, really. Like, I can't think of a worse plan than that one. I mean, the least I can do is try to get the truck in as best of a position as I can before I spawn the trailers on it. So, like, maybe about here would be best, I'm thinking, because we need a lot of room to try to swing these trailers out. Because I can't be coming into that thing with them all crooked and stuff. And if this doesn't work, I could always just trailer down. But I really, really want to try to do it with the double trailer setup because I think that would be the most interesting. So we're just going to go like that to try to swing the trailers as much as I can. And we got to go really slow on this part because I know I can't brake once I start going down it. So like I got to just inch and be as careful as possible right here. Because that back trailer is not straight. And neither is my truck because I'm kind of getting pulled along by the trailers. Oh, this is not good. Oh, this is not good. Okay. Go, gun it. I have no control. This is terrible. Okay, this is not working. So I got a better idea. I'll rotate the vehicle, then drive it down, but the map editor is broken when I have my recording software running, so I gotta do it off camera. I'm really sorry about not being able to show you guys how to do that. That's why I've been trying to avoid using the map editor in videos, because, well, I can't show it to you. It's like, what's the point of making a video if I can't show you how something's done? It's like, that would be so annoying if I was to watch something and have no idea how something was done, and the best description was posted by somebody like me who's saying, hit the little squiggly button that looks like a squiggly, then hit the other squiggly button that looked more like a squiggly squaggly, and it's like, you know, I can't describe those things in text well. It's a lot easier just to say this button that's located right here and, you know, show it with video and stuff, but, well, that's not gonna happen, so I'm just trying to drive this thing straight, which led me to this wall, which it really doesn't matter. It's just a slightly different angle than the other wall. And I think it actually caused a little bit better of a crash with the trailers anyway, so I'll take it. Truck down. Trailer one. It's like a spring. It just coils up so perfectly here. Just coiling right up. And then there goes trailer two in the mix now as well. So even with all of that, the last trailer is still getting pretty damaged up. I mean, that is impressive to watch. And I don't really have enough control over this to make it go anywhere else. So that's going to be all there is for brutal slope. And now all we have left is leap of death. So let's head over to there. For this to actually work, I'm pretty sure I'm going to have to drive the truck all the way to this edge and then put the trailers on it, because if I put the trailers on it there, they would just get stuck in the mountain, which is not the goal here. The goal is to fly down the mountain with the trailers attached, at least until they fall off. I mean, these trailers are mounted pretty well. It takes more than just a simple jackknife to pull them off, that's for sure. All right, so here we go. Road train at super slow speeds. Uh-oh. Okay, different plan. Let's try backing up first and then going forward. Now, I couldn't spawn it going this way, or this far back, I mean, because it would be stuck inside the ground. The only way this will work is if I can have the trailers at an angle like that and then gun it and then make it up that ramp, I don't know. We're going to still be going pretty slow. Power? Power? There we go. Woo! Just barely made it. I could feel the back of the trailer, like, not wanting to make it. So I'll zoom out a ton, and then we'll do this one at full speed. And this camera is not looking at the trailer, which is the part that's the interesting part. I don't care about the stinking truck. I wanted to watch the trailer go down. Which is proving kind of boring. They just stop. Well then, I guess we'll do one of these with slow-mo, and that'll probably be it then, because that was kind of disappointing. Okay, it was really disappointing. I'm not gonna lie to you. That was super duper disappointing. You know what? Here's an easier solution. Let's just do this. Because you saw that was not going well. So we'll get 8x slow-mo on this first crash, which isn't much, so we'll just let it keep rolling down until it gets to like a high impact area, which is, well, that was it probably. The next area over there is also going to be high impact, probably higher impact though. The first one just was a little bit more than I expected, that's all. Yeah, this is really not that fun to watch. Turns out it's kind of lame. Well, I guess we'll end it on a really lame note then, unfortunately, because I don't even want to watch this. It's so boring. And then it disappeared anyway. So, till next time, this is WhyBeAre. I'll see.